discovered coronavirus causes coronavirus disease COVID-19. A coronavirus outbreak began in China but is rapidly spreading around the globe, and on March 11, World Health Organization declared COVID-19 as a pandemic. Every case of COVID-19 leads to roughly 2.3 new cases, meaning the outbreak is still spreading. The causative agent for this outbreak is named as SARS-CoV-2, Severe Acute Respiratory Syndrome, Coronavirus 2. According to World Health Organization, as of March 17, 2020, there has been 1,082,629 cases of COVID-19 and 7,601 deaths. At such time, it is crucial to note that about 26% of the patients have recovered, and most of the patients will recover soon. Patients are discharged after clinical recovery with no symptoms and two negative PCR tests taken 24 hours apart. Upon discharge, they are asked to minimize family and social contact and to wear a mask. In China, the overall CFR was higher in the early stages of the outbreak, which is 17.3%, which reduced over time to 0.7% by February 1. This means that with proper control, the condition can be stabilized. Also, we must note that the mortality rate for COVID-19 differs by groups, that is, if we consider different age groups, then the fatality rate is relatively lower for individuals below 60 years, however, the fatality rate climbs up for the elderly. So the highest risk group is individuals above 60 years. Also, it has been noted that individuals with hypertension, diabetes, cardiovascular diseases, chronic respiratory diseases, and cancer show a high fatality rate compared to healthy individuals. Usually, the elderly group suffers from one or more of these conditions. The goal right now is to flatten the curve. Social distancing measures like self-isolation, sanitization, closure of schools or workplaces, and reduction in person-to-person contact will help in flattening the curve. Currently, World Health Organization published a draft of 41 candidate vaccines in preclinical trials. Also today, Kaiser Permanente Washington Health Research Institute in Seattle is conducting a human trial funded by the National Institutes of Health. It includes 45 young, healthy volunteers who will receive different doses of the vaccine that was co-developed by the NIH and Moderna. A COVID-19 patient after recovery can have blood drawn and screened for SARS-CoV-2 neutralizing antibodies. This serum can be used as a vaccine for high-risk group or as a treatment measure. With many patients recovering from the disease, this treatment method may be successful. Meanwhile, it is crucial to have a highly sensitive and accurate diagnostic tool that will help us to catch every single case of COVID-19. 10 kits based on RT-PCR, isothermal amplification, virus sequencing, and colloidal gold activity are being widely used for detection. Serological diagnostics are rapidly being developed but are not yet widely used. Proper detection would mean that fewer COVID-19 patients are sent back home to suffer from the disease and eventually spread it to others. Typical signs and symptoms include fever, dry cough, fatigue, sputum production, shortness of breath, sore throat, headache, myalgia or arthralgia, chills, nausea or vomiting, nasal congestion, diarrhea, hematitis, and conjunctival congestion. Please get diagnosed if you suffer from these symptoms and stay safe.